From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Hi there, welcome to News 8 Now. I'm Norm Karkos.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Former Auburn music teacher James Raymond is scheduled to be sentenced in federal court this morning.
Now, back in May, a federal judge convicted Raymond of two counts of transporting a minor across state lines with intent to engage in criminal sexual activity. In 2007, Raymond took two sisters, ages 11 and 9, to Canobie Lake Park in New Hampshire. Raymond has been incarcerated before. Now, back in 2008, he spent 60 days in jail after being convicted on five misdemeanor counts for inappropriately touching three young girls.
A man from Berwick is facing a charge of arson. Officials say members of the Maine State Fire Marshal's Office arrested 55-year-old James Bowie at his home yesterday. South Berwick police said the arrest was a result of a three-week joint investigation following a small fire at an abandoned property on Agamenicus Road in South Berwick. Officials say the fire was quickly contained. It was put out. There was no injuries, but damage was estimated at about $2,500.
Drivers here in Portland can expect more delays today because of work on a project to expand the Downeaster service. Beginning after 9 this morning, rail materials will be delivered to Forest Avenue and Congress Street rail crossings. That means significant delays at those intersections. Crews made it through three rail crossings yesterday, ending at the Reed and Walton crossing. At each crossing, traffic is stopped for about 30 minutes at a time, so materials can be unloaded. It all has to be done during the day for safety reasons, of course. And despite some setbacks, officials say the project has been pretty smooth so far.
It's been pretty good so far. They had some delays, but, you know, nothing we can't work around. We've been prepared for the last couple days with police officers and traffic control stuff with cones and barricades and stuff, and on standby as they progress through the city.
The $38 million project will extend Downeaster services to Freeport and Brunswick.
Some big names will be in Maine this weekend, stumping for local candidates with just 4 days to go until Election Day. Former New York City Mayor Rudy Giuliani will be in Portland on Saturday campaigning for Republican 1st District Congressional candidate Dean Scontras. Senators Olympia Snowe and Susan Collins will also be at the rally, taking place on 4th Street. That starts at 11 o'clock tomorrow morning. And on Sunday, former President Bill Clinton will be headlining a rally for Democratic gubernatorial candidate Libby Mitchell at the Lewiston Armory. This will be his second visit to Maine this campaign season for President Clinton and also for Giuliani. An educational nonprofit group in Portland will host its annual furniture giveaway today.
Ruth's Reusable Resources will host the principal's only new furniture giveaway from 8 until 4 at its location there on Blueberry Road in Portland. The event provides principals with brand new furniture for their schools. Last year, more than 66 principals from schools throughout Maine participated, taking away $352,000 worth of brand new furniture and office items.
All right, the day has finally arrived. The new Trader Joe's in Portland opens its doors at 8 o'clock this morning. Store is in the old Wild Oats on Marginal Way. This is video from the sneak peek we got at the store on Wednesday. It features specialty foods as well as basic items, many of which are organic or minimally processed. Trader Joe's has 340 stores in 27 states. This is their first, however, in Maine.
All right, they'll open the doors pretty soon.
We're ready for them.
We are. That's it for this update. I'm Norm Karkos.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us. Your forecast and sports highlights are coming right up.